feelings. And we sing, sing out. We sing, holy is your name.
right, good evening, everybody. How's everybody doing tonight? Good. Welcome to Sunday Night Live at Jubilee. It is good to see you guys here. Let's go ahead and stand to our feet. We're going to jump in to what God has prepared for tonight. And I know it is a great, great, great meeting ahead of us. So, Lord, right now we just lift up our hands. We lift up our voices. We just declare we want nothing else more from this time together than to be in your presence and to lift you up, to make you known, declare who you are, and see you come and change us, come and revolutionize our minds, our hearts. God, come and do something we've never seen before. Let us discover something in you brand new, God, because you never end. You're always new. There's always something new. So Lord, tonight, God, I pray that you would just push us to a place in worship we've never been before, God. Push us to a place in your presence, a place in your intimacy, a place in you. God, no matter the cost tonight, let us go somewhere we've never been before. We don't want to leave the same, God. So we come to give you a worthy praise, a worthy offering. Look upon this place tonight and find sons and daughters that are giving you a worthy praise tonight. We've come for you. We're here for you tonight. So Lord, we lift you up. You are welcome here, Holy Spirit. Come and have your way. In Jesus' name. Amen. Can you put your hands together for the Lord? Let's welcome him here.
Burn for you. outstretched hands. We reach for you.
Come on, tell him.
My open heart burn for you. Outstretched hands. Reach for you. I reach for you. Lord, in my heart there is a hunger. In my heart there is a fire. Lord, down in me there's a burning desire. It's you I want to know. It's you I want to see. Come and walk, come and talk, come and dwell with me. Lord, in my heart there is a hunger. In my heart there is a fire. Lord, down in me is a burning desire. It's you I want to know. It's you I want to see. Come and walk, come and Lord, in my heart. Lord, in my heart there is a hunger. In my heart there is a fire. Lord, down in me there's a burning desire. It's you I want to know. It's you I want to see. Come and walk, come and talk, come and dwell with me. You are welcome here. You are welcome here. You are welcome here. Mighty God.
Come on, let's just tell him one more time.
My open heart, Lord, we burn for you. Our outstretched hands reach for you. Open hearts, they burn for you. Outstretched hands.
Come on, we reach for you tonight, Jesus. Tonight we burn for your presence.
Open hearts, burn for you. Outstretched hands, reach for you. Open hearts, burn for you. Outstretched hands.
In my heart, Lord, in my heart there is a hunger. In my heart there is a fire.
Lord, down in me there's a burning desire. It's you I want to know. It's you I want to see. Come and walk, come and talk, come and dwell with me. Lord, in my heart there is a hunger. In my heart there is a fire. Lord, down in me there's a burning desire. It's you I want to know. It's you I want to see. Come and walk, come and talk.
Come on, invite him.
In my heart there is a hunger. In my heart there is a fire. Lord, down in me there's a burning desire. It's you I want to know. It's you I want to see. Come and walk, come and talk.
One more time.
Lord, in my heart there is a hunger. In my heart there is a fire. Lord, down in me there's a burning desire. It's you I want to know. It's you I wanna see. Come and walk, come and talk, come and dwell with me. You are welcome here. You are welcome here. You are welcome here, mighty God. You are welcome here. You are welcome here. You are welcome.
Before we jump into the next song, let's just take about 2 minutes and welcome your neighbor. Give somebody a big hug, tell them hi, and tell them you're glad to see them in church tonight. No other place I'd rather be than here tonight, and we're glad you joined us here at Jubilee Church. All right. We'll be right back. How many of you are happy to be at church tonight? All right, that's like all of us on stage. How many of you guys out there are happy to be at church tonight? All right. How many of you guys are excited about Accelerate Conference this week? I believe, there we go. Somebody's awake. You guys can stand up. Stand up. We're going to jump right back into praise and worship. I just believe as we worship tonight, as we praise and the Spirit moves, He's just preparing our hearts for what's happening this week. Anybody agree with that? I believe some incredible things are in store for us as a house this week and as people come from all around the world. And it's not about coming here as much as about being here altogether. It's not about this exact building, but I believe it's about this exact people that God's going to pull together this week. And I believe there's just going to be a explosion in the Spirit. And I just want to make sure that my heart is ready to prepare and to receive it. Amen? So tonight, just feel the Lord running the tiller on the ground of your heart to stir up the soil and get it ready for what's going to be planted. And I believe He's already going to begin planting some seeds tonight in worship. So just go there. Tonight is not a night that you should keep anything in reserves or anything held back. Tonight is the night to give it all and to empty yourself out in worship. Amen? Well, let's praise Him a little bit more. How about that? Here we go.
Never let me go.
Hold me.
preacher.
Praise you, Lord. Praise you.
Strongholds over the lives that are going to be in this house for the conference this week. I believe that as we lift up praise, that you're pulling down strongholds over the homes that are represented in this house tonight, God. So Lord, as we lift you up, we believe that walls are coming down. As we lift you up, we believe strongholds are coming down tonight. Because in the sun of rain, I'm going to praise your name. In the sun of rain, I'm going to praise your name. In the sun of rain, I'm gonna praise your name. In the sun of rain, I'm gonna praise your name. In the sun of rain, I'm gonna praise your name. In the sun of rain, I'm gonna praise your name. In the sun of rain, I'm gonna praise your name. In the sun of rain, I'm gonna praise your name. In the sun of rain, I'm gonna praise your name. In the sun of rain, I'm gonna praise your name. In the sun of rain, I'm
are now. As the praises rise, the walls fall down.
Walls fall down.
Oh, you're pulling walls down. You're pulling walls down right now. You're pulling walls down. You're pulling walls down right now. You're pulling walls down. You're pulling walls down right now. You're pulling walls down. You're pulling walls down right now. He's pulling walls down. He's pulling walls down right now. He's pulling walls down. He's pulling walls down. Still in the business of pulling walls down. Lord, you're still in the business pulling strongholds down. Lord, you're still in the business of breaking chains now. Yes, you're still in the business of erasing stains now. Breaking walls down, breaking walls down. Wall down, he's breaking walls down, breaking walls down. Break my wall now, Lord. You're breaking walls now, breaking walls now. Break my walls now. You're breaking walls now, breaking walls now. Break my walls down. You're breaking walls now, breaking walls down. Break my walls down. Breaking walls down.
It's different when we go from singing about his ability to do it in totality. And when we make it personal, when praise gets personal, praise gets powerful. When we worship, when you worship him and you call on him and you say who he is out of the most tender place in your life right now, what that is doing is it's putting him on the throne in that place of weakness. And it's making him strong in your weakness. And there's power in that praise. Like if we look at Paul when he was in prison, as he began to lift his praise in his place of weakness, the prison began to shake and the shackles loosed themselves and there was a freedom spot. There was a freedom moment. It wasn't woe is me worship. It wasn't roll over on my side and you know, death and despair. I believe Paul probably sang something like, you're breaking walls down, you're breaking walls down, break my walls now. You're breaking walls down, you're breaking walls down, break my wall now. You're breaking walls down, you're breaking walls down, break my wall now. I know you can. You're breaking walls now, you're breaking walls now, Lord, break my wall now. Can you give him your wall tonight? Breaking walls down, you're breaking walls down. Break my wall now. I know you can. You're breaking walls down. Come on, church, we're going somewhere. Give him your walls tonight. Hey!
You're breaking walls down. You're breaking walls down. Break my wall now. You're breaking walls down. You're breaking walls down. Breaking walls down. Breaking walls down.
You're
loosing chains now, you're losing chains now, loose my chains now. You're loosing chains now, you're loosing chains now, loose my chains now. You're loosing chains now, you're loosing chains now, loose my chains now.
Hey!
You're loosing chains now, you're loosing chains now, loose my chains now.
Hey!
You're loosing chains now, you're loosing chains now, loose my chains now. You're loosing chains now, you're loosing chains now, loose my chains now. You're loosing chains now, you're loosing chains now, loose my chains.
You're changing names now, change my name now. Make me new, Lord.
You're changing names now, you're changing names now, change my name now. You're changing names now, you're changing names now, change my name now.
You're breaking walls down,
you're breaking walls down, you're breaking walls down, break my walls down. You're breaking walls down.
Tell him one more time.
You're breaking walls down. You're breaking walls down. Break my walls down. You're breaking walls down. You're breaking walls down. Break my walls down.
Lord, I believe you've come to break some walls, to loose some chains, to change my name. Lord, we already feel your spirit here. We already know you're here among us. Come and have your way. Come and have your way, come and have your way now. Come and have your way now, have your way now. Have your way now, have your way now, have your way now. Come on, tell him. Have your way now, have your way now, have your way now. Give him permission. Have your way now, have your way now, have your way now.
Way down,
come on, church, give him permission. Hey,
have your way now, have your way now, have your way now. Have your way now, have your way now, have your way now.
Sing glory rain down,
glory rain down, glory rain down, glory rain down. Glory rain down, glory rain down, glory rain down.
Jesus, have your way, Lord. Come and do what you will, Lord. We're yours tonight. We are completely yours, God. We won't fight back against you tonight, God. Pull us whichever way you want to. Lord, we'll move with your wind tonight. Holy Spirit, come and do what you want to do. Lord, find us willing, find us available tonight.
desperation. We long to see your face and be changed by.
Won't tell him you're welcome.
Lord, you're welcome this place. Come have your way.
You are welcome here. Come take your place. Set the atmosphere. You are.
More than I've ever needed you right now.
Quick for me, if you don't mind. I'd like for you to just have a seat. We're going to sing this song again. But as we were worshiping just a little bit earlier, I felt like I heard the Lord say we have a diminished view of who He is. We have a diminished view of who He is. That means that we don't see Him like we should see Him. And when we don't see God like we should see Him, then everything else in our lives, it sets the tone for everything else. Now, in Matthew chapter 28, it's one of my favorite passages of Scripture. This is after the resurrection of Jesus. And see, even that in and of itself, man, we lose that. We lose the glory of that. We lose sight of the fact that for 3 days He was literally dead. He was physically dead. And just like He said He would, on the third day, He resurrected from the grave by the power of the Holy Spirit, bringing vindication to everything that He had taught, absolutely saying, listen, I told you I was the Son of God. Now here is the evidence. I was alive, I was dead, and now I am alive forevermore. See, we're still not celebrating like we should. We still don't get it like we should. And so in Matthew chapter 28, Jesus, the Bible says, Jesus came unto them and He said, all authority has been given unto me in heaven and on earth. Can I just go in on that just for a little bit? See, because we're singing a song about stepping out in faith. But if we have a diminished view of God, you will never step out in faith. We'll sing about it. We'll get goosebumps about it. We'll have good music about it. We'll get stirred up emotionally about it, but we'll never do it. How many of you believe this is a season for us not to just sing about it, not to just scream about it, not to just cry over it, not to just get goosebumps over it, but to actually step out and do something that we've never done before? To go places that we've never been before. To reach people that we've never reached before. To build things that we've never built before. To invade territory that has yet to be invaded, all for the glory of God and by the gospel. So when Jesus said, all authority has been given unto me in heaven and on earth, here is what He was saying. Everything in this created order, oh my goodness, that we call earth, And everything in the created order that we call heaven, he was saying, I am firmly fixed as the king and ruler of it all. See, you still don't get it, man. We still don't get it, but I'm praying that by the time we leave this place tonight, we'll have a greater understanding of it. Because that's why passion is cold. That's why worship gets all robotic. And we feel like it's more of an obligation than a passionate response of being overwhelmed as to who Jesus is. So he says, all authority. You know what Jesus was saying? Here's what he was saying. I run everything. I run everything in heaven, and I run everything on earth. It's all mine. It's all under my jurisdiction. See, your first father, Adam, rebelled against me. But I was sent by my father on a mission, and I have reclaimed everything that has been lost. I have reclaimed all of the authority. So there may have been a time where demon spirits were running rampant and free in the heavens and in the earth. There may have been a time where the forces of darkness were in control on the face of the earth. But when the Son of God came, my Bible says that he disarmed every principality and power, and he made a show of them openly by triumphing over them through his victory on the cross. Here is what that means. That means every devil, every demon spirit, every force of darkness, every principality, and every power, Jesus stripped them completely of their power, and he led them in a kingly processional for all of the universe to know that they had been soundly defeated. But we don't live like that. We don't pray like that. We don't worship like that. We don't witness like that. We don't praise like that. We don't engage the world like that. See, somehow we think that there is still some kind of back and forth going on. Somehow we tend to think that there's some kind of yin and yang type deal going on. That there is some type of balance force between light and darkness. Let me tell you something right now. Ain't no competition. That there is no competition. There is no question as to who is in charge. There is no question as to who is firmly seated on the throne. There never has been, there isn't one right now, and there never will be. So when Jesus said, all authority is given unto me in heaven and on earth, then he gave a command. He says, here's what I want you to do. I want you to go. Everybody say go. Come on, we're talking about accelerate, right? He said, I want you to go. Everybody say go. He said, I want you to go to every nation. See, they weren't just going on their own ability. My God, man. They weren't just going because they had good ideas. They weren't engaging the nations just because they got stirred up from some itinerant preacher. No, they had literally been walking with God himself. And so when Jesus said, go, when Jesus said, go, they knew that literally all of the power of heaven was behind them. And that is why when they encountered opposition, they never stopped. When they were beaten, you couldn't stop them. When you put them in prison, you couldn't stop them. When people threatened them, they didn't stop. When they were reviled and kicked out of cities, they never stopped. When people drug their names through the mud, they never ever stopped. As a matter of fact, they had these crazy mindsets where they said stuff like Paul told the Philippians. He said, for me to live is Christ and to die is gain. You can do whatever you want to do to me, but you can't stop the spread of this gospel. Jesus said, go. And do you know what they did? They went. I believe that the Spirit of God is bringing us back to a place, some of us all over again, and some of us for the very first time, where we are going to encounter the reality of His sovereignty. And we're going to encounter the reality of His power. And we're going to encounter the reality of His greatness. Not so we can have good church. Not so we can just come to meetings. No. So that when He says go, we go. So that when He says speak, we speak. When He says go to this nation, we go. When He says go to this neighborhood, we go. When He says minister to that person, we actually do it. We're not arguing with them. Now listen, we are so concerned with how people see us, and we are so concerned about being rejected. We are so concerned about our little measly, stupid reputations, that when God says go, here is what we do. We don't obey immediately. See, there was this guy that used to preach here all the time for years and years. And he used to say, you know what the fear of the Lord is? He used to say, the fear of the Lord is doing exactly what God tells you to do when He tells you to do it, no matter the cost and no matter the circumstance. And I believe that God is bringing us face to face with that truth tonight. I believe God is bringing us face to face with that truth tonight. The reality that there is a God who is really sovereign. That there is a God who is absolutely in control. And Jesus cut no corners when He talked about Himself. He said, listen, you're going to be scared of them? You're going to be scared about what they can do to your body? You might want to be concerned with the one that can destroy both your body and your soul in hell. That's the one you might want to be concerned about when you're sitting there being concerned about your reputation. When you're sitting there being concerned about whether or not your coworkers are going to reject you. When you're sitting there thinking about whether or not your neighbor's going to think you're crazy or somebody out and about. And He said, no, you better get your eyes on Me. I'm a lot bigger than you think I am. So again, we suffer from a diminished view of who Jesus is. But I'm hopeful tonight, and I'm so grateful tonight for the Holy Spirit, because Jesus said, I have many things that I'm gonna say to you, but I'm not gonna be here for much longer. So here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna send you a comforter. I'm gonna send you a paraclete, and He's gonna be with you, and He's gonna be in you. And Jesus said, everything, He's not going to speak on His own authority, but what He hears from Me, He's going to deliver to you. And that same Spirit is here in this place tonight. And that's the same Spirit that lives on the inside of you and I. And so this song talks about, Spirit, lead me to where my faith is without borders. God, let me walk on the water. Man, I don't want us to sing this song and not encounter the truth that it was written on. And when I was sitting there, I was thinking, as I was standing there, about Peter. We know this story, but we don't live it. I said, we know this story, but we don't live it. Peter did not walk on theoretical water. Peter did not walk on hypothetical water. Peter literally got out of a boat. He was a real man in a real boat in some real stinking water. And here comes Jesus, the God-man, defying the laws of gravity. Like gravity says that everything, no matter what the weight is supposed to be, is supposed to accelerate at 9.8 meters per second. But Jesus wasn't accelerating at 9.8 meters per second. He literally was walking on water. Now, how is it that gravity didn't apply to Him? How is it that those laws that we learn about in school didn't apply to Him? Let me tell you something. When you're the creator, When you're the creator, your creation doesn't tell you what to do. And so the very earth that he entered was the very world that he created. So he said, if I want to walk on water, I created it. It's mine. I'll walk on the water I created. You don't tell me what to do. I tell you what to do. Some of you are starting to get it, man. Some of you are starting to get it. And so Peter is sitting there. And they see him and they don't really understand who he is. And here's what he says. Peter says, if it's you, God, if that is you, out there in the realm of impossibility, if that is you, out there beyond my understanding, God, if it's you, out there beyond my wildest dreams, Jesus, if that's you, out there beyond anything that I could ever imagine, Jesus, if that is you, beyond anything that I could ever conceptualize in my finite mind, then here's what I want you to do. I don't want to stay right here in the realm of possibility, but if that is you in the realm of impossibility, if that is you in the realm of miracles, if that is you in the realm of the supernatural, I don't want to stay where I am. Here is what I want you to do. I want you to bid me to come. If that's you, no, stay right there, God. Stay right there. I don't want to stay where I've always been. I don't want to keep doing the things that I've always done. But Jesus, if that's you, I want you to bid me to come to where you are. God, I want you to bid me to come to where you are. I want you to give me a word, God. Lord, if it's you, God, if it's you that's stirring this thing up on the inside of me, if it's you that's given me this dream, God, if it's you that's given me this vision, if it's you, God, that has this thing stirring up on the inside of me, then you just stay right there. And here is what I need you to do. All you gotta tell me is to come to you, God. And when Peter heard the word of Jesus and say, come, all of a sudden he did what no man could ever do on his own. All of a sudden he was defying the laws of gravity, just like his Savior, just like his God. And I don't know about you, but if Jesus is walking on water, then I want to walk on water. If Jesus is in the realm of impossibility, I want to be in the realm of impossibility. If Jesus is out there someplace that makes dead religion uncomfortable, then that is where I want to be. If Jesus is out in a place where doctors say it's impossible, then that's where I want to go. If Jesus is out in a place where secular science says it's impossible, then that's where I want to go. That's where I want to live. And I'm telling you tonight, I hear Jesus saying, come, come. Some of you have been saying, God bid me to come, God. If that's you, I'll do it. If that's you, I'll start the business. If it's you, God, I'll go back to school. If it's you, God, I'll start the ministry. If it's you, God, I'll do it. And he's saying, it's me, it's me, it's me, it's me, it's me, it's me. Now step out, come on. Now we're gonna begin to sing this song again. And we're gonna sing this song with some understanding. I want you to stand to your feet right now. Oh, he's telling you to come. And there are those under the sound of my voice in this place. Oh, this is more than a song to you tonight. There are some things stirring up on the inside of you. And if that's you, let's just use our imaginations tonight. Let's just pretend that Jesus is saying, come. All right? Let's just see you can hear him just like Peter heard him. And here is what I want you to do. In just an act of faith, in just a symbolic act, I want you to get out of your seat and I want you to make your way down here to the front, just saying, yes, Lord, I'll come. That's you, God. That's you, God. It's you. I'm not going to deny it any longer. I'm not going to be afraid any longer. I'm not going to be scared any longer, God. Some of you keep talking yourselves out of the promise of God. Some of you have allowed your past to take this thing away from you. But I'm telling you right now, your past don't define you. The God of the impossible is out on the waves, and we're here sitting in the boat, and he's saying, it's me, I want you to come. It's me, I want you to be where I am. It's me, I want you to come to where the impossible is now possible. It's me, I want you to come to where miracles happen. It's me, I want you to come to where you are strengthened. It's me, I want you to come where there is salvation. It's me, I want you to come where there is deliverance. It's me, I want you to come where there is vision. It's me, it's me, it's me. Now here is what you gotta be prepared to do. You gotta be prepared to leave everybody else in the boat that doesn't wanna follow you behind. See, they might be calling you crazy. They might be questioning whether or not you've heard God. They might say you look like a complete fool. But sometimes you gotta look like a fool when you follow Jesus. That's why you gotta leave your reputation at the door. Come on, are we ready to follow him? Are we ready to follow Jesus? Are we ready to follow Jesus? I want to see the impossible. I want to see the impossible. I want to live the impossible. Oh, if that thing on the inside of you is too big for you, then good. If it's beyond your understanding, then good. If it is far above anything that you could ever do on your own, then good. He's calling us there. Come on, he's calling us there. Come on, just begin to lift your voices to him. Just begin to lift your voices to him. Come on, come on. We're going to sing this song with understanding. And we're going to go there. We're not just going to sing about it, but we're going to live it. 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 And we're going to sing this song with a new understanding. Come on, just worship. Just worship. Just worship. Just worship. Just worship. Come on, guys. We're going to just sing this song again.
You call me out upon the waters.
Come on, he's calling us out.
The great unknown. My feet may fail.
With new understanding and revelation.
There I find you in the mystery. In oceans deep, my faith will stand.
Lift your voices and sing.
And I will call upon your name.
We'll call upon you, God.
And keep my eyes above the waves.
Above every circumstance and every
when
problem.
When oceans rise, my soul will rest in your embrace.
Grace
abounds in Jesus' words. It's time.
Come on, lift your voice. Come on, call on him. Come on, call on him. Come on, we're not going to live comfortably. We're not going to live life on the shore. But we want to go where he's calling us. Wherever he's calling us, that's where we want to go. Jesus. Oh, wherever you would call us, God. Do it, Father. Belong to you, and you're the perfect dad. You provide for your sons and your daughters. You're always faithful, and you never fail. Everything that you say you're going to do, you do. Every word that goes forth from your mouth does not come back to you void, but it literally accomplishes the thing that you've sent it out to do. Lord, we believe you tonight. We believe you tonight, God. Right now in this moment, some of you, your circumstances have been bigger than God. And God is visiting you with a fresh perspective tonight. He's shifting your attention off of your issues. And he's shifting our attention off of our weaknesses. And he's shifting our attention off of how big the problems may seem to be. And he's fixing our eyes firmly on him. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we thank you. We thank you. Come on, let's just hang out here right now, because somebody needs to know this tonight. I need to know this tonight, that when God speaks, even though it doesn't make sense, and even though it looks like it's impossible, we can obey. And when we obey, it's not the circumstances that will hold us up. It is literally the word that God has spoken. The very God who upholds all things by the word of his power. So when he says go, we can go. And when he says speak, we can speak. And when he says act, we can act. And when he says give, we can give. When he says sow, we can sow. We can obey. We can obey. We can obey. How many of you want to live a life of radical obedience unto the Lord? You want to live a life of radical obedience to the Lord. That means you want to live a lifestyle that when God speaks, you don't argue, you just do. You don't argue, you just do. I don't live a life like that like I should. Sometimes I get distracted by circumstances. And sometimes I'm more concerned about about what people think than I am with the fact that the creator of the universe is speaking to one of his created beings. And when our perspective begins to be shifted, we see the absurdity of us having the audacity to not move when he says move. When we begin to understand how big and how great and how mighty and how awesome and how majestic he is. Oh, he's good, but he's all powerful. Here's what I want us to do. Here's what I want you to do. I want every person right now to go back to your seats. And as you go back to your seats tonight, here's what I want you to do. I want you to grab an offering envelope. I want every person to take one. It's one thing to talk about being obedient. It's one thing to sing about being obedient. But it's another thing altogether to actually be obedient. And when it comes down to matters of tithes and offerings, really lets us know where our faith is. But I want us to do something tonight. We're headed into a conference. And saints, I don't know about you, but I don't want it to just be wasted time. I don't want it to be wasted time. I know it's not going to be. But I don't want to wait until Saturday night to try to figure out what's going on. I want us to charge head first into this thing. Stir it up. Not trying to go somewhere, but actually bringing the somewhere with us. Actually bringing the move of God with us. To where we're not in here trying to make something happen on Wednesday night. But we're here and we're saying, God, I've been hearing you all week. You've been stirring me up all week, God. You've been speaking to my heart, God, all week long. And Lord, I can barely contain it. I'm ready, God. We're ready. I want us to ask the Holy Spirit what he would have us to give tonight. So many times, man, I don't know about you, I have this little calculator in my head that after I've calculated like my tithes and stuff like that, and when it comes down to offerings, I have this little calculator in my head that says, well, let's see, I have this amount of money in the bank, and so I can afford to actually give this amount. You know, the amount that makes me comfortable. Maybe you guys are a heck of a lot more spiritual than I am. But man, I'm tempted to go there all the time, specifically when it comes down to the matter of giving. And in that moment, even after coming out of amazing worship, some of you have genuine financial need in this room. And I don't say that lightly. There are genuine financial needs represented in this room. And I'm going to tell you something right now, man. I don't believe in gimmicks when it comes down to giving. If I were to just speak very plainly to you, I believe the judgment of God is going to fall on that stuff. But here's what I believe. I believe that there are moments where God calls us to do things that don't make sense. Where he calls us to do things where in the natural it seems absurd. But just as Peter heard a word from Jesus and he said, I want you to come here where I am. I believe that there are times where God does that because he wants us to know that he is the real source. He wants us to know that He is the one that meets our needs. We say we trust God, but if we were honest, there are so many other things that we put our trust in. So many other things that we hang on to. So many other things that we rely on. And I'm going to tell you something tonight, saints. And I'm going to go ahead and preach it to myself. God loves us too much to let us hang on to our idols. Do you hear me? He loves us too much to allow us to hang on to anything that is not worthy of worship and honor and praise and radical obedience. And He says, I know this might be a little painful to you. I know that you might not understand this. But you've got to know that I'm all you've got. I want us to ask the Holy Spirit what He would have us give tonight. Conventional wisdom would say, it's a Sunday night crowd. It's not that many people here. Surely it's not going to be a good offering. Well, I don't care about conventional wisdom. I care about what God is saying to His people. And I care about where God is taking us. And so we're not going to give some dry, obligatory offering. We're going to hear God tonight. I don't believe in telling people how much to give. That's not my place. That's not my place. But I believe that Jehovah Jireh is in this room tonight. And I believe that God wants to take us to places that we've never been before. And I believe there is so much more that God has in store for this church. But we are not going to get there playing it safe. Do you hear me? We're not going to get there playing it safe. We're not going to get there playing it close to the vest. We're going to get there by moving and acting in faith. So here's what I want you to do. I want you to begin to ask the Lord right now, if He hasn't spoken to you. I want you to ask the Lord. And whatever the Lord lays on your heart, that's what I want you to do. Father, we're all standing here before Your presence tonight. And God, You don't call us to give according to gimmicks. But Lord, You know our hearts inside and out. And You know that I have a tendency, that we have a tendency to rely and trust in and hold on to everyone and everything but You sometimes. Father, I pray that You would speak to our hearts. There are people in this room, God, that are walking through genuine financial hardship. And so, Lord, we know that it's not about the amount, but it's about the obedience. It's not about the amount, it's about the obedience. Father, by Your Spirit, I pray that You would begin to speak to each and every person in this room. By Your Spirit, that You would begin to speak to each and every person in this room. And when the Lord gives you that amount, write the check, take out the envelope, fill it out. Because before you come up here and just drop it in a bucket, we're going to give in faith and we're going to give in obedience tonight. I don't know a lot of things, but there have been key moments in my life where God has placed his finger on something. And he said, that's got to go. I know the other person is doing it. And I know that it's not necessarily right or wrong. But I'm telling you, it's got to go. And it's in those times it gets scary. Sometimes it's downright painful. But what I have discovered is that on the other side of my obedience, there was a faithful God. On the other side of the sacrifice, there he was. And when you discover that there is a faithful God on the other side of your sacrifice, that there's a faithful God on the other side of your obedience, all of a sudden, what you have to give up doesn't seem like that much any longer. Because you see more clearly than ever the one who really matters. I'm giving you some time. If you're making your checks out, make your checks payable to Jubilee. But we're going to give tonight. And I can't say exactly what God is going to do. But here is what I can say he won't do. And that's fail. That's fail. He won't fail. He won't fail. How many of you heard the Lord speak to you? I'm bringing some accountability in the room right now. How many have heard God speak to you a specific amount? You don't have to tell what it is. Don't matter what it is. But you've heard God. How many of you have heard God tonight? You've heard him. You've heard his voice. I want you to step out. And I want us to obey. I want us to obey. And we're going to continue worshiping the Lord in our giving. When you have your offering envelope filled out, here's what I want you to do. I want you to stand to your feet. So many times, man, we give and we treat it so flippantly. We treat it so flippantly. We treat it so flippantly because in our heart of hearts, if we were honest, we really believe that our jobs are our source and not God. But when you know that he's your source, you're not just in a rush to run up and throw an envelope into a container. You're standing there. You're saying, God, I trust you in this moment. That I've heard your voice. And that you're speaking to me. And Lord, I trust in this moment that you're my provider. Not my job. Some of you are dealing with things, issues, man, that you need divine intervention. And I'm not saying that there is a dollar amount that can sway God. That's not what I'm saying. But what I'm saying is this. There is something about sacrifice that humbles us. When we put ourselves in a position where we say, God, you got to do something. You got to do something. And here's the amazing part. If it's him that's speaking, it's not our name that's on the line, it's his name. And if you read the book, you'll discover that when it comes down to his name, he will not allow his name to be profane. He will not allow disgrace to come upon his name. He redeems for the sake of his name. And he provides for the sake of his name. And he heals for the sake of his name. and he delivers for the sake of his name, so that when it's all said and done, nobody's saying, oh, look at me, I got such big faith. But when it's all said and done, we're all humbled at the greatness of God and his ability to do the impossible. And I still believe he's able to do the impossible. And I know that in this season we've been tempted to shy away from it. But I still believe he's able. I want you to take your sacrificial offering tonight. And if you haven't given your pledge for Revision, you need to do that. We got a little ways to go, but we're going to finish Revision. Amen. We're going to finish it. We're going to finish what we started. And so if you haven't done that, you need to be faithful to do that. But you have your offering before the Lord. I want you to lift it up before him right now. And I want you to begin to worship him. I want you to begin to worship your provider. I want you to begin to worship your creator. I want you to begin to worship your sustainer. I want you to begin to worship your healer. I want you to begin to worship your deliverer. I want you to begin to worship your advocate. I want you to begin to worship the one who gives you strength. I want you to begin to worship the one who gives you wisdom. I want you to begin to worship the one who, when it seems like it's impossible, he's the only one that can invade it and bring you out. And as they begin to lead us in worship again, here is what I want you to do. Man, just when he leads you, I don't want you to just come here and throw your money or your check into a bucket tonight. I don't want you to do that. But what I want you to do is I want you to give in genuine faith. And I want it to be an act of worship. So you might just have to hang out at your seat for a bit. You might just have to hang there just for a couple of minutes. Because when you come down here and you put this offering in, we want it to be in the full assurance of faith. We want it to be, you know what, God, you're my provider. So that when you come here and you deposit this offering tonight, you do so when you're expecting. You're expecting, God, I don't know how, that's up to you. I don't know when, that's up to you. I don't know by who, but that's up to you. All I know is that you spoke. And you're able, and you're my God, and I obey. Come on, just wave your offering before him, and just begin to worship. And when you're ready, I just want you to begin to just come forward and just begin to give. We're giving in faith tonight. We're giving in faith tonight. Lord, we give in faith tonight. We give. And as you give, just remain standing.
My child.
here to blind your eyes to circumstances in your life. And when we were talking, when he was talking about Peter walking on the water, there was a key to what he was doing. He had to keep his eyes locked on Jesus' eyes. And the moment that his eyes drifted off of Jesus' eyes and he began to see with his eyes the wind and the waves, fear immediately gripped him and he began to sink. And I just heard God say when Pastor Aaron was sharing that, he is going to blind our eyes to circumstances. There are waves and there is wind and there are things around our lives that we get our eyes off of Jesus and we're like, oh, but what about that? And all of a sudden this sinking feeling hits you because you can't fix it and you can't stop it. But Jesus said, if you will put like blinders on and if you will lock your eyes on the eyes of Jesus, this week, some of you are going to see supernatural peace to the wind and the waves and the storms that have been raging in your life. And I just heard that so clearly. And you've got to leave tonight with that faith in your spirit that you're not willing to look anywhere else but to Jesus. It's that simple. It's that simple. Come on, just raise your hands. Come on, we're just flowing in the Spirit tonight. Don't be in a hurry. It's not about an agenda tonight. It's about whatever God wants to say over you. We don't spend enough time in His presence. That's why we're not changed. Everything is in His presence. Everything you need for your life, it's in His presence tonight. Don't leave here the same way you walked in. Don't be satisfied. Come on, I challenge you right now to lock your eyes on the eyes of Jesus. I want y'all to raise the music. It's been very quiet. I want you to get aggressive. Come on, lock your eyes on Jesus tonight. Lock your eyes on the eyes of Jesus. Where is your Savior? Find Him. Find Him. Find Him. Find Him tonight. Lock your eyes. Lock your gaze on His tonight. Come on, don't look at the waves. Don't look at the waves. Come on, I will call.
Borders. Wherever you would call me.
say new season, new season, new season. And there has been a boundary like borders around you that you did not see how there could be a new season. A new season just means it wasn't as hard this week. But God said, no, it's a new season for you. It's a new season over your life. It's a new season over your family. It's a new season on the calling that's on your life. And when we were just singing that, Jesus, take me. Well, I'm going to go. Lead me wherever you're calling me. The rest of your life is about walking on water. The rest of your calling is about walking on water. It's an everyday walk for you. But there has been a hunger and there has been a crying on the inside of you for something fresh and something new, and you've been pursuing it and pursuing it. And God says, I'm running this week to meet you. I'm running this week to meet you where you are. These are not just words tonight. It's a new season. Hear the Spirit of God. These are not just words tonight. Everything is in His presence for you. You don't see how it could change, but I'm telling you, change is coming. Change is coming. Holy Spirit, I just release right now supernatural strength over Beth, and I release supernatural life over her. I release, God, a new faith, a new season, a new trusting, a new energy, a new passion, a new vision over her. It's all new. It's never going to be anything that was. It's all new. It's all new. It's all new. I'm telling you, everything comes out of our eyes being locked on His. When your faith is shaken, your eyes have to be locked on Him. God, we take you so seriously tonight. Holy Spirit, your presence is so valuable. It's so important. It's so valuable to us. We cherish it. God, we cherish your presence. God, let expectation begin to rise in us. Let expectation begin to rise in us like never before. Thank you, Jesus. Stephanie, I just heard God say that the struggle, there's been a struggle like a tug of war for about 6 months, 8 months in your life. And God said, the struggle is over. You've been seeing me moment by moment, favor by favor. But God says this time the struggle is ending, and there is a solidness under your feet like you've never felt before. There is such a confidence that has come on you in this season of your life. And I just heard God say that there is boldness, confidence that's going to rise up in you, and things are going to come out of you you didn't even know that were possible. Words of wisdom, words of strength, creative ideas, creativity that is beyond what even you could imagine. And there's been a contentment to just be behind the scenes. There's been a contentment to just be, okay, whatever is needed. I hear you. Whatever is needed, whatever is needed, whatever is needed. And God said that has not gone unnoticed. And in the next few weeks, you're going to see Him begin to use you in the most unusual ways and the most unusual places. And I don't know what all's been happening, even in your physical body, but I heard God say, I'm healing you tonight. I am healing you. I don't know if there's something you know or it's just been bothering you or something, but God said, I'm healing it. I'm taking care of it. I'm completing it tonight. Every symptom has to leave her body right now in the name of Jesus. But I just see I just keep hearing the word solidness, a new confidence, a new strength. It's going to be a season where there will be no fear to trust. Absolutely no fear to trust. Not in people, but in God. Absolutely no fear. Holy Spirit, we just release that over her right now. I release, Holy Spirit, a new level of confidence, of trusting you, of believing, God, whatever you say, that there would be no fear, no fear. Just fill her up tonight. Fill her up to overflowing tonight. Fill her up. Come on, just stretch your hands toward her. We just release right now. Fill her up supernaturally. Fill up her spirit, God. Fill up her life. Fill up everything, God, in her life for all that she gives out. Fill it back up. Fill it up. Fill it up. Fill it up. Fill it up. Come on, just get it all, Stephanie. Get it all. Get it all. To know what it feels like to breathe without pressure in life. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, I will call. I will call upon your name, Jesus. Come on, there's such an amazing presence of God.
I will call upon your name.
That's all it takes.
And keep my eyes above the waves. When oceans rise, my soul will rest in your embrace. For I am yours, and you are
time. I will call,
and I will call upon your name,
Jesus,
and keep my eyes above the waves. When oceans rise, my soul will rest in your embrace, for I am yours, and you
belong to you. We belong to you, God. We belong to you. How many are glad you came to church on a Sunday night? Can we just give him glory tonight? He's good, amen. He's so good. He's so good. Well, listen, we've got a lot of church this week, right? We're so thankful and appreciative of everyone that will be serving, that has served leading up to this conference. But we're going to go ahead and dismiss here in just a bit. But we don't want to do that first without saying, man, if there's, God has just been speaking all night tonight, and I feel like it's just been a refreshing here in this place tonight. If there's anything that you need prayer for, I'd just like some of the prayer team and the ushers to hang out just for a second. If there's anything that you need prayer for and you just want somebody to just pray for you, pray with you, we're going to wait here just for a bit. But if not, we're going to go ahead and pray and dismiss tonight. And take this with you, just like Angela said, this heart, this mindset, that he would begin to just keep stirring in us and stirring in us all week long. All week long. So, Father, we thank you for giving us this night. We thank you, Father, for your God who speaks to your people still. Through your word, by your spirit, you speak to us, O God. And you strengthen us. You give us wisdom. You give us direction. We are so grateful for that tonight, Father. Lord, as we leave this place tonight, thank you that you refresh us in your presence. Even as we sleep tonight, God, let there be a refreshing, oh God. And Lord, I pray that you begin to stir up words of prophecy, words of wisdom, words of knowledge. Lord, that we would, that your revelation would stir on the inside of us like never before. That as we come back into this place on Wednesday night, we're going to be so stirred up and ready to go. Nobody's going to need to pump us and prime us, God. We're going to be ready to enter in. And we pray against any scheme of Satan that would come against us. And Lord, we're just going to rehearse your victory over the forces of darkness. So Lord, we thank you that your presence would continue to keep us, oh God. And you would order our steps in your word. Thank you for speaking to our hearts. Thank you for encouraging us and strengthening us. We love you. We give you glory for it. Somebody just give him a big loud amen. Amen. Come on, one more time. Just put your hands together and give him glory. He's awesome. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Well, thank you so much for being here tonight. Continue to keep your ears open to what the Lord is saying throughout the course of the week. We're going to have an amazing time this week. Amen. God bless you. We love you. Amen.